Welcome back, everybody. You are watching the Look Up Atlanta coverage on Peachtree TV. We are so excited to be here. We are excited you're watching, and we are really excited about this event. It is back after a two-year hiatus, celebrating 25 years this year.
25 years, a quarter of a century, and my goodness, have folks been counting down to this moment. Here at Centennial Olympic Park, obviously, we're seeing a lot of people starting to trail in.
Yes.
They're not letting the what was rain, you know, rain on their parade or on their fireworks, because
exactly.
People have been looking forward to this event, and this is always a great time for the city of Atlanta to come together to really recognize what Atlanta is all about.
Yeah.
And just to get to see everybody, like, it's good to finally be back with people.
I mean, again, 2 years, that was of course because of the pandemic. We couldn't do this. So this is the first time you can scratch that itch of getting out 4th of July with your family. Lots of things. They really planned this out well.
Yeah.
Lots of things to do. Lots of good food to eat, lots of food trucks around, just being around the people. I mean, it's electric out here.
It is. And now we're still about 3 hours away from the big fireworks show, but there's so much going on out here right now, it really doesn't even matter. So you're taking a live look right there, just showing you some of the vendors and all of the good food that is out there, which is, of course, what I know a lot of people are looking forward to. You can hear some of that music in the background. Got a little Outkast going right now. We've got a DJ on the stage. And I'm telling you, this really is electric, as you just said.
Yeah.
Because it just shows you that things are becoming normal again.
Yeah.
We've been in this place for so long, and it's felt even longer than 2 years, depending on where you live.
Yeah.
But if you're visiting in town here in Atlanta, we're going to give you the Atlanta experience.
Yes, we are. Speaking of the Atlanta experience, what a perfect segue, Brooks Baptiste. I'm proud of you. Look Up Atlanta has 5 A's that we are celebrating.
Yes.
One of them happens to be appetite.
Appetite.
That is what we're going to talk about right now. I love food.
Me too.
We got some great food options here in Atlanta, and a lot of them went through a lot to make sure they could still be here today. Of course, the pandemic hit a lot of people really hard, and we actually got to talk to some businesses about what it was like during that time and kind of being on the other side of the pandemic, and that's what you're about to hear.
That's the turkey wing.
This is the sound of resilience. Of restaurants now on the other side of a pandemic that wreaked havoc on the industry.
It was honestly like a downward spiral.
March 2020, a month restaurant owners will never forget.
It was probably the hardest month ever in my professional career.
Stockyard Burger and Bones owner Alexis Kenzie says for some restaurants, it was a death sentence.
When you had to shut down without any awareness that was going to happen, you're really draining any reserves that you possibly have. And unfortunately, a lot of restaurants didn't have that.
Georgia Restaurant Association CEO Karen Bremer says restaurant owners took desperate measures trying to save their businesses.
People were cashing out their 401ks. People were taking loans out. There were restaurateurs that sold their homes, moved into apartments to take the equity out of their house to keep their business going.
Ultimately, even restaurants with decades of history like Zesto and Buckhead Diner were forced to shut their doors for good.
We believe that approximately 4,000 closed permanently.
But amongst stories of loss is a story of unity.
All the restaurateurs are competitors, but yet in our state, restaurateurs came together to get advice from each other.
We had neighboring restaurants just brainstorming together. I mean, it was, you gotta think, like, we're not a health department. I don't know how to take a temperature.
But together they figured it out and began to innovate, creating delivery and takeout only formats, alcoholic beverages to go, and QR code menus. It was innovation that brought Peach Cobbler Cafe to Buckhead.
During COVID, we said we wanted to come up with something new.
Co-owner Alri Alston says it was originally a sit-down burger place called Big Al's Butter Burger that closed due to the pandemic. So they came up with a takeout soul food concept.
Everything was to go, so people didn't have to worry about sitting around eating amongst people.
Little did he know it would become a hit.
After that, it was history, man. When I said one from the customers coming in the door, and next thing you know, the frenzy started.
Brimmer says it's this spirit of perseverance that allowed Georgia restaurants to bounce back.
I was incredibly proud of the resilience of our industry, how restaurants figured out how to stay in business. We had it pretty good in the state of Georgia.
I mean, how incredible is that? I think a lot of people can relate to one of the business owners who said, I am a restaurateur. I had to figure out how to keep people healthy, how to take their temperature, how to make sure they didn't get COVID. I mean, what a time to be alive. I know it was very stressful for them, and I'm so proud of them for kind of getting to the other side of this.
And that's right, but that just shows you the resilience of a place like Atlanta.
Yes.
You know, Atlanta wasn't stopped by the pandemic.
Right.
Atlanta rose to the occasion like so many other cities and like so many restaurants here in this city. And I think that just goes to show you exactly what Atlanta is all about. And that's why an A like appetite is so important, because we understand that is a big part of what Atlanta is. But to see a place like this really say, hey, we're not going to be stopped. We're going to adapt.
Yep.
We're going to do what we have to do, and then we're going to keep it moving. And now things are back on the right track for sure.
Yep. All right. And speaking of keeping it moving, we've got Rodney and Tori somewhere in the VIP section.
Uh-oh.
I'm still trying to figure out who let Rodney in VIP.
Uh-oh, just Tori, actually.
Oh, okay. That's why he's not there with you.
Okay this
I see.
Time.
Now we see.
Well, guys, we're here. We are here, and we are excited about it, because even though most adults are out here, they also have their kids, and it makes you want to feel childlike, right? So I got my face painted with the CBS 46, got the nice balloon hat, which is also free. They're both free when you come in here. And guess what else they have? Crown and cornhole. So we're going to put Rodney Harris over here to the test, because look at him. He thinks he's got this one.
Are you ready to lose? I can't even hear you. But are you ready to lose?
You know what? If I start to lose, there's going to be something called a Cooper comeback, and it's going to be loud and proud. Okay, so I'm going to throw all four of my bags and try to get it in the hole or just get it on the board. Okay, here we go. Oh, the first time. I played this game yesterday for like the first time. All right, here we go. Oh,
two.
You want to pay me? You want to pay me extra for this? Oh, no. Rodney, you really got your work cut out for you. Oh!
You've done this
three?
Before.
Who am I? Okay.
Finally, she lost.
Okay,
she
Rodney,
got
it's
one.
Your turn, Rodney. Go ahead.
For the record, I've never done this before in my life. All right, here we go.
Oh.
I'm terrible.
You got this. Oh, no.
Sorry, Ron, I hit our photographer.
All right, it's okay. You know, I'm used to winning, but come over here. We're going to see if you can win this one, because guess what? Everyone's pretty much a winner, and that's why we're going to choose Rodney to do this one. Look at this. You can spin the wheel. Oh, we're having some cute family members doing it.
Those
okay,
are
guys,
cool.
Are you having a good time?
Rodney.
Are you having a good time?
Hello!
Rodney,
there
we
go!
She's so
it's
excited
nice
to see
us.
What
are
you
guys
all day?
What
just
happened?
We watch you guys.
We
all
watch
day.
You all day. We're the number. We watch you guys every day.
Oh,
thank you for all of you watching.
Oh. What did you win? You don't even know what you go see. What you want? Oh, a hat.
That's
put
cool.
It on, put it on. We need to see the community out here. Oh, this is yours now.
Hi. Thank you, CBS. Peachtree TV.
Peachtree TV. All day. And
y'all have
fun. They have live Jenga over here. They have Connect Four. So if you're feeling competitive and you want to have a good time, this is certainly the place for you. And it's all free, Rodney, right?
I don't know. It's free for us, but I'm sure that you can get in. Just come say hi to us and we'll let you in.
Yeah.
Congrats on your win.
Thank you.
You cheated because I've never done it before. And I'm a sore loser. So as soon as we're done, I'm going to be so annoying for the rest of the night.
You'll put your hat back on.
So I lost my hat. All
right. Oh. We're going to send it back to you, Lana Brooks.
Wow.
Rodney, you started with, are you ready to lose? And ended with hitting the cameraman with a bag.
Rodney talked all that junk.
Exactly.
And still got put to shame.
And Tori just lands too. Are you in the right profession? You know there are professional cornhole
Tori,
players.
I'm impressed, Tori.
I'm impressed.
Rodney, don't quit your day job, all right, my friend? Don't quit your day job. We're going to leave it at that. I love it.
We will say VIP is $40.
$40
for adults,
yes.
$20 for your kids. But you get a lot out of it.
It looks like it's worth it over there.
Absolutely.
I'm telling you. So you get your food, your drinks, obviously the games. You get up close and personal to the big stage as well. So I think that's going to make it worth it, if nothing else as well. All right. So we've been talking about the five aspirations of Look Up Atlanta. But let's tell you a little bit more about Look Up Atlanta and what it really means.
Have you ever thought about what makes Atlanta, Atlanta? What is it about this place where the tree line defines the skyline? The city in the forest. where black meets white as one, too busy to hate. We're a mix of red, gold, black, and blue. Yeah, we see you too, GSU. The Metro is now home to more than 6 million. Originally founded as the central point of several railroads, once a hub of transportation, always a hub of transportation. Home of the world's busiest airport and a diverse economy. Aerospace, logistics, healthcare, news and media, film and TV, sprinkled in with some IT. The CDC, fintech and history, civil rights, 1996, and the largest urban redevelopment program in the United States, the Beltline. So if you're wondering what makes Atlanta, Atlanta, it's you, me, us, coming together as one. Look around, then look up, Atlanta.
Look up, Atlanta. Yeah. And that is what we're doing right now.
It makes me proud to live here. It makes me proud to be from here. I know you are from Jacksonville, Florida, so.
Yes, one of the greatest cities, but I gotta say.
Behind Atlanta.
But I've gotta say, though, Atlanta, this is home. This is home, and I do love Atlanta. Guys, we are here at Look Up Atlanta. The fun is going on right now, and of course, there's so much more to go.
Yeah, and just in the show itself, we've got Tracy and Rob coming back. We've got different live guests that you're not gonna wanna miss hearing from. So stick with us. We'll be right back after this break.
Watching the Look Up Atlanta celebration on Peachtree TV. Sponsored by Georgia Furniture Mart. Saves you money.
Welcome back to Look Up Atlanta on Peachtree TV. You may be at home and maybe you can't come out to downtown Atlanta tonight to watch the fireworks and be a part of this huge party down here. But if you can come out and you're packing things up to go ahead and come on out, go ahead and do that now. There are ways you can get down here. Take MARTA. It's a lot easier. There's parking over by the Georgia World Congress Center. There's three different decks where you can park at if you'd like to come out. Tell you what, bring a clear bag, bring a blanket, bring some low beach chairs, and bring a little something soft to put, you know, a couple of bottled waters in. But you can come on out and have a great time. Hey, thanks for watching the broadcast here. I'm Tracy Hutchins.
I'm Rob Hughes. It's impossible not to have fun out here. And a lot of that credit should go to DJ Yvonne Monet.
The ones and twos.
Got a quiz, Tracy, on that. So it was beautiful to see a little bit of some of our reporters. We saw Harry and Sierra, a little new school, a little old school. They were making fun of themselves about that. We've seen what they've been seeing, the drum lines, the cornhole. Rodney and Tori were hilarious on that. There's a lot of things to do. There's food trucks. There's a, you know, want to get your good spot to watch the fireworks. And what I've seen is a lot of people have their chairs here, but certainly we saw a lot of rain earlier, and there's people still sitting on the grass, so it must not be too wet out there.
It's not too bad. Tell you what, the rain is gone for now. I think we've talked to our team of meteorologists. We're going to be safe tonight. The great thing, it has literally brought the temperature down by as much as 15 degrees. It is so much cooler out here now than it was a little bit earlier, so we are happy about that. And there's lots of areas you can visit. Of course, the main stage, there's a kids' zone here, face painting, all those good games too. Of course, the Olympic rings fountain if the kids need to cool up just a little bit. And of course, the VIP section. That's $40. You still have time to scan our QR code. That'll get you $5 off the general admission, so save you $5 on that. So general admission only $5 to get in. The VIP tent, though, I hear that is the place to be, because for sure they've got some tasty bites there and some goodies and covered, so you will have a front row seat to the fireworks. That will be amazing tonight.
So it's a little bit of a mystery box or a grab bag, if you will, when we send it out to our reporters here in the park, because as we mentioned, there's so much to do. We last left Harry and Sierra at the drum line. Fortunately, they left it to the drum line. I advise that for the rest of the evening. Harry, Sierra, what are you guys up to now? Tell us where you're at.
Again, we keep lucking out with the best shot, okay? Not that it's a competition, but if it were,
We'd be waiting, okay? We're at the food trucks, Harry.
Oh, this is good. There's so much good stuff here, and the prices are reasonable.
Yeah.
For coming down here for this, I mean, it's good stuff. Who do we have here?
You know what? It's pretty special because a lot of these businesses are family-owned, just like the Soul Food Truck. We've got Soraya here. She's got a fancy display for us.
What are you looking at right here? You're looking at the veggie flat burger with macaroni sauce, just sauce. Okay. And, yes.
And the interesting thing is you're only 14. Tell us a little bit about your family business.
Okay, so when I was little, my uncle passed, Willie B, and so his sister just came up, Willie B Sisters. And so we have other family business, but Willie B Sisters was everybody who come together, arguments and everything just come together to Willie B's. Best soul food in town.
Yeah, you know what? The food always brings a family together. This is a really popular dish they have. So I'm going to hand off my microphone to my producer, Adriana, and I'm going to show you how they eat it.
All right, here you go, Adriana.
I'm not even sure what this is. So what are we doing here? Why am I holding a bag of chips?
Soraya's going to walk us through. So first of all, this smells so good. It's spicy.
Spicy.
What's in it?
Okay, so it's hot sausages, pickled hot sausages with jalapenos and pickled eggs, jalapenos and banana peppers.
All right, yeah, the smell.
Crunchy pickles.
It's so good.
So okay. Where do the chips come in?
So we crush it, right?
You can. Ruffles bring all the flavor.
All right, so
they do?
Yes.
All right.
Okay, we're gonna dump it in here. And we're gonna have Harry try some of
why,
it.
Why is it
we're
mean?
Gonna try. We're
what?
Gonna
no,
try.
Wait, I'll do it.
Okay, we love it. We love it, okay?
All right.
So then we just.
Because I love anything pickled and anything hot.
I'm scared of spicy, but I know I'm gonna love
Come
it.
Come on. Let's see.
Okay, get it with the hot sauce.
Get it?
I'm
get
trying.
It. That's. Oh my God.
That's good, but wait, I gotta get a pickle.
Oh my God. Okay, we're gonna keep going.
All right, we're not done with the food here, folks. Hang on.
Oh, so good.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing.
That is delicious.
You've got time to come out here to the soul food truck. They've got everything you need, but we got one more spot that Harry wants you to check out.
All right, so let's go over here to the food truck here all around the world. Michelle?
Hi.
Hi. So we're on live TV. Yay.
Hi.
And this is a chance for you to show. First of all, what's the name of your restaurant? How did it start? And where can we find you?
My name is Michelle. I'm with All Around the World, and you can find us anywhere around Georgia, actually.
Is there one place in particular that you guys go?
We go to Truck and Tap Alpharetta a lot.
All right, so what have you got here for us?
This is our gyro plate. It has lamb, our signature garlic sauce, and a lot of veggies in it.
Here, let me hold it up here because I want people to see this. So tell us again what's in this, because this looks really good. And you may not get it back.
Go ahead, take it. It's French fries with our signature garlic sauce, some lamb gyro from the spit, and some fresh veggies.
All right, and the lines aren't too long here right now. And you guys are still keeping pretty busy, huh?
Absolutely. We always try to give our food in a minute or two.
All right, I took the mic away from her. But listen, thank you very much. Have lots of business. Make lots of money tonight, okay? All right, folks. That's it here. These are just a couple of the food trucks, but I mean, they go on in this direction down here, and you can see the lines aren't bad right now. I mean, you come down here and get some really good food, and it goes all the way around the corner. I'm not going to make you go all the way around there, Dimitri, but in any event, this is a good place to be, and it's not too crowded right now. I think because of the weather, people thought that, oh, we're not going to go to Centennial Olympic Park. Well, you know what? You should still come here, all right? I'm going to throw it back to you guys.
I'm just glad that you are talking into the mic, Harry.
At least now I am.
I had to get that jab in. I had to. Look, Harry's one of our best. He's been with us for a long time.
Yes.
And fantastic to see him by the food truck.
You can't blame him. He's really excited about the food. And to be honest, it's making my stomach growl just seeing it.
You
so
can smell
I'm
it. It's
jealous.
Been about a half an hour, and the smells have started to pick up. The sounds have been going for a while, but the smells are starting
I
to hit pretty
so.
Strong.
You know what would go very good with a meal?
I can think of one thing in particular.
Ice-cold Coca-Cola. We do want to welcome in our guest, Allie Terry. She's
hey
with Coca-Cola.
There.
How are you?
Good. How are y'all?
Welcome,
well being here.
Yes,
and we're matching.
I know. Look at the red. Well, you've got to represent Coca-Cola. You got
to
wear red, right?
America, Coca-Cola. It's a pretty good combo, right?
Yes. And the thing about Coca-Cola, it is a universal brand. I love to travel, whether it's Europe, South America, North America, anywhere Caribbean in the country, they know Coca-Cola. We know that brand so well. I mean, that's got to be a great thing that Coca-Cola is so associated, so embedded here in Atlanta.
we're so thankful that it is a global brand, most recognized brand in the world. But we also like to pride ourselves as a local bottler. Coca-Cola Bottling Company United operates in 6 states. We have 48 sales centers all over. So we really pride ourselves in the local community. So.
1886.
Yes.
That was when Coca-Cola was founded.
Yes.
So there's a lot of companies that have been around for a long time, but they don't necessarily stick with where they were founded.
Yes.
Coca-Cola has.
Yes. So we were actually founded, Coca-Cola United, which is the bottling side
right.
of it, was founded in 1902, and we're headquartered in Birmingham. But, of course, we have sell centers all over. So Coca-Cola is everywhere, and we're glad to be here. So
yeah, and that's one of the tourist attractions, too. I mean,
yes.
you've been to the World of Coke, have you, Rob?
I've not been to the World
oh,
of Coke.
Oh, my
However,
goodness.
As an avid Coca-Cola fan, and really Diet Coke specifically.
You tried them all.
I told my buddy Rodney Harris, if you put Coke Zero, Diet Coke, Coca-Cola, some other different company products in there, I can tell you exactly
Blind
what
good.
Is
right?
Coke, Diet Coke, Coke
Look
Zero.
Look at you.
Sure.
Yeah,
I promise
you that. We have our new Coke Zero Sugar in our VIP Village, so be sure to try,
nice.
Try it out.
We'll
but if you're a Diet Coke loyal, then we'll just keep it.
It's
out.
Hard to stray from Diet
yeah.
Coke.
Yeah.
But visiting the world of Coca-Cola, I mean,
yes.
you get an opportunity to try many of those.
It's on the list.
Coca-Cola.
Yes.
It is on the list. See, you know, we'll give him a break. It kind of came during the pandemic,
yeah.
so he's okay. We'll let him slide on that. But, you know, I have to say, I was born and raised in the West, and I did drink that other brand. I'm a convert now.
Okay,
since,
good.
Yeah, almost
that.
20 years
We're
in Georgia, and I can literally only have Coca-Cola.
Good.
But being here in Atlanta and being such a part of the community, what are you most looking forward to? What is Coca-Cola most pushing forward to looking ahead? That, you know, it almost feels like a resurgence, of
yeah.
course, Atlanta resurgence.
Right.
But after the pandemic, that we've
yeah.
all kind of come alive again and have this renewed hope
yeah.
for all those things that are yet to be.
Yeah. Well, really excited when Jim brought this to us. Us with Georgia World Congress Center. It's all about celebrating Atlanta. So we hope when you think of Atlanta, you do think of Coca-Cola. But internally, a lot of things we're looking at are initiatives, World Without Waste. So y'all will see recycling bins everywhere and signage that says, you know, drink, recycle, repeat. That's a big push for us, World Without Waste. We're, of course, always recruiting the next generation. We want you to join Coca-Cola in one of our 48 sales centers and build a career there, retire there. So that's another piece. And, of course, pouring into the youth throughout the city. We're proud to be a part of what we call Pay It Forward, which is HBCU internship program. That'll start at the end of July. So really excited about that.
That
near and
exciting.
Dear to my heart. So
yes,
yeah.
very
yeah.
exciting.
So intertwined here. And,
yeah.
and Coca-Cola, we sit there, we know that. We know
yeah.
the can of Coke.
Yeah.
We know Diet Coke, whatever. But we're talking 200 products.
Yes.
Or 500 products,
yeah.
200 countries.
Yes.
Let's not downplay that.
yeah.
There's a lot that Coke has its hands in.
Yeah, a lot of people don't realize how many brands we do have.
Right.
It's almost at 750 plus
oh my
now
gosh.
Okay.
globally. Like Minute Maid Aguas Frescas, we came out with that in March. That's a new juice beverage for us. You'll be able to try AHA, which is our sparkling water here. So it's not just Coke and your Diet Coke and Coke Zero Sugar. We have a full line. So.
Yeah. Yeah. The world's changed a lot, and you guys are at the forefront. You're
yes.
talking about zero waste, and people are health conscious, too.
Yes,
so
absolutely.
As much as I love Coca-Cola, I think I want to have it when the time is right.
Exactly. That's why we have mini cans and different other
exactly.
packages for everyone to enjoy. So.
That's got to be sometimes overwhelming, trying to,
yeah.
you know, you're marketing a lot because
yes.
you're, you know, with marketing with Coca-Cola, with all those different brands, kind of trying
yes.
to keep track.
It is. It's madness, but we love it. It's all fun. So
a lot has changed since
yes.
the first Coke
that
product
is right.
in 1886.
That is right. Yeah.
Thank you so much for being here.
Yeah,
Allie Terry
you.
With Coca-Cola. We appreciate your time. Thank you. We're going to have
thank
to head
you.
On down to the tent, right? So what can we try at the tent? We can try.
You can try AHA, which
uh-huh.
is our sparkling water. We have tons of flavors there. And then Coke Zero Sugar.
Perfect.
Yeah.
I've got Diet Coke
we might have to
and
you
AHA in my fridge
yes.
right now at
love
home.
It. Love
I
it.
Promise.
Thank you, Allie.
Thank you.
It. All right, we are certainly having a great time here for Look Up Atlanta on Peachtree TV. Look at all those people. Those spaces are starting to fill. Oh, look how cute
she is. The red, the white, and the blue.
The red, white, and blue. Oh, she's dancing for the camera. She is too cute. Oh, so many little ones out here and so much to do while they wait for the fireworks and while you wait as well. We will be back right here on Peachtree TV with more Look Up Atlanta. We'll see you in just a bit.
Thank you.
back to Look Up Atlanta. We're taking a live look behind the scenes there. I do believe this is the Atlanta Symphony Youth Orchestra. They're behind the scenes. They're getting prepped because, Rob, they are one of the performers that will be on the stage later on tonight. So they're just kind of getting everything situated. And the great thing is this youth orchestra, they only pick the best of the best when it comes to being a part of the Atlanta Symphony Youth Orchestra. ASO, you know, if many of you have seen their performances as well. We're talking about the next generation of performers, kind of growing them up.
Incredibly talented group of musicians at a really shockingly young age in some cases. I was reading a little bit about them, and there can be as many as 300 people audition to be a part of that orchestra. Right now, this year, there's 115 who actually made the cut, and I imagine that the ones who didn't make the cut and part of that 300 are still some really good musicians. So it is very competitive to be a part of this really prestigious organization.
Yes, and they will be playing during the fireworks tonight. Some of the other performers you'll be seeing as well, Angelica Hale, only 14 years old. If you're watching the show earlier, you heard Brooks and Lana talk about Angelica, and she's actually been on Wake Up Atlanta, hasn't she?
She has, and I can't even tell you how impressive of a young woman she is. I just wasn't doing the things, or even close to the things she's doing, thinking about being a part of, and then that's not to mention her talent, which is undeniable.
Absolutely.
It just doesn't make sense how a 14-year-old girl of her size could sing the way she does. It is beautiful.
Yeah, she competed on the 12th season of America's Got Talent. We had a chance to listen to her kind of during her dress rehearsal. An incredible voice for such a little person, kind of, you know, small and wrapped up in there. And also, too, of course, we'll see a performance by the Georgia National Guard flyover. That's going to happen about 7:57. They're going to fly over. Those flyovers are so spectacular whenever you see them. And you just get this sense that overwhelms you of being proud as an American and everything that, you know, we've come to love about the country and the freedoms that we have here. And this is a weekend to celebrate it.
Black Hawk helicopter. Have you seen a flyover of a Black Hawk?
I haven't.
I've been a part of many flyovers. I've seen the stealth bomber. That's fantastic. Fighter jets, you name it. But I've never seen a Black Hawk helicopter. They're incredible vehicles, though.
Yeah.
222 miles an hour. It's just part of what makes a celebration like Look Up at Atlanta, the celebration that it is.
Yeah, don't blink. You might miss it. Yeah, going at that speed, right, depending on how low they are to the ground. So much going on out here this evening. Of course, we have a kids' area, a play zone that kids can go and get face paintings at, lots of balloons. We have our own crew. Some are coming back with balloons as well. It's really a party for us here at CBS 46 and our sister station, Peachtree TV, because this is the first time we've hosted this event, because Look Up Atlanta, brand new. Of course, fireworks have been going off here in downtown Atlanta for a while, but the first time we have a celebration like this with food and performances and a large stage and the fireworks to kind of culminate all of it. So it is so exciting to be a part of.
And you're starting to feel that slow build with the DJ and the people filing in and the food starting to smell delicious. And you see the young people out there having a good time running around, just the buildup of the fireworks. And it strikes me every time we take one of those shots of Centennial Olympic Park, what a beautiful setting this is, surrounded by all of the really cool things to do here in downtown Atlanta. We're talking 22 acres of beautifully manicured green space. It looks like we're at Augusta National Golf Club.
It does.
The grass is incredible.
But this grass you can actually sit on, lay on, play on.
That's right. And you won't be promptly kicked out. You're encouraged to sit on this grass.
Yes.
$45 million went into Centennial Olympic Park back in 1996 and the years leading up to the 1996 Atlanta Olympics. And you can tell, I mean, it's just one of these parks that strikes you as maybe a little different than a lot of other parks you go to.
Oh, absolutely. So much to offer. And that's what today is all about, is an opportunity to celebrate Atlanta and all that we have to offer. Let's check in with some of our crew members out and about. You know these two are always getting into trouble because they have been for the last hour or so. Let's head out to our Rodney Harris and Tori Cooper to see what they've gotten into, because I know you guys were trying to sneak into the VIP club, right, into the VIP lounge. Okay, Tori, can you hear us?
And they're planning for us.
Hey, tacos? Go ahead and bring them over.
Hey, Tracy.
I heard tacos.
We're going to make the tacos. You know,
know, I'm going to pick who gets the tacos, okay? But I am joined here with two beautiful women out here from El Ponce, ATL. They're two women who run this taco restaurant down the street from Ponce City Market. Good evening, Jarena and Rosia. How are you?
We're great. Thank you.
And what does it mean to be out here?
It means a lot. As a small business owned by two women, an independent business that represents Atlanta out here, it's a big opportunity and we're excited to be here.
And you're seeing some really anxious customers. You have a long line right here, and luckily we have Chef Rod over here who's going to make the tacos. He's going to make some chicken tacos out here, so go for it, Rod. All right, so talk about some of the ingredients we're seeing here.
So we have, we do a lote, which is a Mexican street corn, and then we have a mushroom adobo, which is a vegan option. We do a carnitas. And Rob's going a little wild there because he's not doing chicken at all, but that's okay. And there's chicken at the end, so.
There's chicken everywhere.
Yeah.
Okay, so you really have an option for everyone. Now talk about some of the toppings.
So we kind of made a taco bar here so everyone can top it as they like. We've got lettuce, sour cream, cilantro and onion traditional with a little lime. And then we also have some guac and salsa if people want to add that on, and some agua fresca that we make.
Okay, you make scratch. From scratch. Mm-hmm. Agua fresca from scratch. That's so yummy. And to represent Atlanta and be front and center in the VIP section, I mean, that's got to mean a lot for a small business like yourself. You said the pandemic was hard, and this is these moments like this you really depend on.
We do. It's everything to be out here, not just for selling and making money, but marketing our business and letting people know who we are and that we're still here. Yeah, no, we made it through.
Right, you made it through. And on a positive note, now you have all these people who are excited to have some of your tacos. And anything else besides tacos they can get out here?
So they can get the elote, which is a Mexican street corn. They can get some chips with either guac or salsa. And then we have agua frescas that are like a sweet drink that are typical in Mexico.
Okay, so what is your business model? How about that? Let's leave our viewers with what you guys stand for and maybe just, you know, what you guys really aim to make sure everyone leaves with it. You remember how you taste, you remember what you feel when you're there.
So for us, our mission is to create a safe space where everyone is welcome with fast, fresh, affordable Mexican food. So for us, being on Ponce, we're really tied to our community, and that means a lot to us.
Community ties, and they taste good.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to see who decides to get the taco. We're going to give it to Rod.
And I got something special. So we have the guac with the chips. We have the tacos, but we have to do something special for Rob. So, Rob, I'm going to combine the chips and all the meats just for you, buddy. We're going to send this back just for Rob. I'm going to put everything on there, Rob. So don't worry, buddy.
Okay. All right, Lana, Brooks, pick it up from here. You guys, we know that Peachtree TV is anxious to see what else there is to offer throughout the park.
You're saying Rob. Why does Rob get that
Where's
taco?
Where's our food?
Hello?
If one Where is our food?
Don't bring back some tacos to this stage. There's going to be a problem.
Look,
that looks amazing.
I am setting a timer. Y'all got 10 minutes to figure it out and bring us some tacos back here, okay? Because we are hungry.
Great
we
job.
Can use a little something.
Look, who knew Rodney was so talented?
Is he?
He could make a taco.
Was he back there burning something up? Or was he really making some tacos back there? Hey, you know, that just, again, shows you what Atlanta is all about. We know the food. There are so many restaurants that I have on my list right now that I still haven't been able to go out and actually get to.
And honestly, this is a great place to try a bunch of different options.
Yeah.
What are you doing right now? You're on your couch. You're in your pajamas.
Come on,
you're eating
down.
A bag of chips. I'm describing my own Sunday, so I know what you're doing. Come out here instead. Eat some of these incredible food trucks. I mean, it's an amazing time out here.
And there are so many of them out here. We're watching the crowd grow and grow
yes.
right now. And guys, we've still got a couple hours to go before the actual fireworks happen. But man, oh man, I see so many smiles on faces.
Yes.
I see so many people grooving and dancing. That just, again, shows you we're back.
Because I know a lot of people, too, thought it might rain.
Yeah.
It did.
Mm-hmm.
It did a while ago.
And it's out
it's
of the
gone.
Way. It's out of the way.
Come on out here.
So nothing should be stopping you. You know what's really interesting about a place like Atlanta? We've been telling you guys about the five aspirations. So we've talked about appetite,
yes.
talking about food. Accommodations happens to be another one.
We've got some incredible hotels in this city.
Have you just been around the city and everywhere you look up Atlanta literally,
yeah.
and then you see another hotel
yeah.
and another hotel. But it makes sense because we have so many people coming into
yeah.
the city, they've got to have somewhere to stay, right?
They stay somewhere, and they're all built differently. I feel like you can go to a really modern hotel, a really old hotel, one that's been here for a while. It's updated. I think that whatever you like personally, you can find it here in Atlanta, hotel-wise.
Yeah, and I think one of the greatest parts about it is when you talk about, okay, so you've got your modern designs that maybe have been here for not too long. Okay, but then you have those that look just like they were when they were originally built, whether they were a hotel or not. And there's one place in particular that is preserving a century-old design.
Everywhere you look, there's something bright and shiny that pops up at you.
Here at the Candler Hotel, every detail nearly takes your breath away.
Immediately, as soon as you walk into the lobby and you've got this ornate, beautiful staircase. We have original Tiffany glass. The chandeliers are original.
A step forward is like a step back in time.
We have the original mailbox from the building, 1906. The majority of the flooring in the building, so look at this wonderful tile flooring, and it's all original, so you'll see some flaws and they will stay there. Because we will plan to maintain the integrity of the historical value of this building.
Now, before becoming a hotel in 2019, Director of Sales and Marketing Michelle Bradley tells me the Candler was an office building. In the lobby area, you can still see the 116-year-old hardware for the elevators. And you even see the original directory with names of prominent businessmen like the late Johnny Cochran.
That's what makes us different from other historic properties in the Atlanta area.
These marble columns have stood for more than a century, holding up this building with layers of history. But if you're lucky enough to go underground,
welcome to the vault. This is where the original recipe for Coca-Cola lived for a very long time.
And that recipe happens to still be one of the biggest trade secrets in the world.
Asa Candler, who's one of the co-founders of Coca-Cola, was the Candler building.
So each time you walk into the Candler, you're walking into an experience.
Whether it's going into the restaurant, whether it's walking into our lobby, whether it's pulling up out front, we want everybody to leave with some sort of tidbit, a piece of history that they can take away. So it's all about the experience.
What an incredible hotel.
What an experience that hotel is.
I was so mad I didn't get to go with you on that shoot. Oh, man. So while we're talking about incredible hotels, we would be remiss if we did not talk about the Omni Hotel. We have Ramon Reyes here. You're the general manager. I mean, I'm looking at it. I know you guys can't see it. But I feel like
it's
I could
right
throw
there.
A stone and hit
yes,
it right
yes.
there. Oh. What is it like to be so close to the action here in Atlanta?
It's awesome. Well, first of all, thank you for having me. And I can't think of a better location to be at, right? We have, it looks phenomenal from this perspective, but from up there, the view is even better.
Yeah.
So to be here for such a fantastic event over such a special occasion and what it means to the city and certainly what it means to our industry is certainly a special to be part of.
Yeah.
You talk about being in a centralized location. What does that mean? You obviously have a very important role in bringing folks to the city, right?
Yeah, well, look, we're the heart of the city, but to be located sandwiched in between State Farm Arena, CNN Center, and obviously the GWCC or the Georgia World Congress Center is not too shabby of a location.
Not too shabby. You're also pretty close to Mercedes-Benz.
We are, definitely. So concerts, events, conferences, we're part of all of it. So we're pretty proud.
All right, you got to check it out. Thank you so much for being
Thank
here.
You.
We appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
And we will be right back after this quick break.
Centennial Olympic Park, Peachtree TV presents the Look Up Atlanta Celebration.
Well, welcome back. You are watching Look Up Atlanta here on Peachtree TV, and we are so excited that you're with us this evening. Talk about having a great time just seeing the city of Atlanta out here, seeing the DJ up on stage. You are in for a treat.
You are, and even like we just showed you Skyview, there are so many things you can do in the area while we wait for the fireworks to come in. These are not paid actors you're seeing, people. It's packed. I was
a little
worried when it started raining. I know that's the first thing everybody thinks. Are people going to show up? The people are here.
Atlanta is here, and that is what we like to see. And when we're talking about Atlanta, I know two people that we need to get to.
Oh, yeah.
We need to get to Sierra and Harry Sambler. Let's see what they've got going on out here right now. Hey, guys, how's it looking where you are?
You know what? I have got a treat for y'all. It is such an exciting time right now. We've got people out here playing soccer, jump roping, double dutching. Our very own Better Call Harry. Look at him. He's trying to get it. He's trying. Don't be defeated, Harry. You can do this. You can do this, y'all. You have to look at his face because he's taking it so serious. I think he's truly heartbroken when he can't get over the rope. Okay, come on, Harry. You got it?
On live TV. I'm gonna get one of these.
You've gotta just get one. It. Just one. We believe in you. CBS 46, Peachtree TV. Yes. Oh, so close.
Last one.
Last one.
This is my Olympic debut.
We believe in
okay.
you, Harry.
Two, one, two, one.
Oh,
almost.
Oh, boy. So close.
I don't think I can do another one of these. I don't know if you can hear me. I just want to thank you.
I appreciate it.
For making me look really bad on television. However, I'm happy to be here, aren't you?
I'm very happy to be here. Double Dutch Aerobics. You can follow us on Instagram. We're just out here having fun. I brought my ropes up just to have fun and look what we got now.
And
so
we got some kids here doing it. Better to have them do it than me. Wait, should we show one more time? One more time.
Okay, one more time.
One more time.
Harry is hogging
one
this
more
line,
time.
Y'all. He is determined.
I'm never gonna live this down.
To win.
Ready? Okay.
All right, Harry, we believe in you.
I almost had it.
You almost had it.
Huh?
But you know what? We're not going to hog the line anymore. These kids, we want to show you the families out here just waiting for this line, making the best of it. You know, earlier today, it was wet, rainy. People are now passing time, waiting for this fireworks show to start. It's such an exciting time. They're patient with every jump roper. They come in, they start jumping, and then they turn the ropes. Oh, yes. See, Harry, that's what you couldn't do.
Well, she was watching me, and she, come here. You learned what I did wrong, and you took from my mistakes, and you went with it. And I'm just really happy that I can help you get better with what you do. All right, guys, back to you.
He failed miserably. Back to y'all.
Oh. You know what? You love a guy who
alive?
Perseveres.
One,
you tried.
Two,
he tried.
Yeah, you're still on.
And he's still trying.
You're still jumping. I thought you were supposed to do it with both feet.
Not just the one. Yeah.
So, Harry, you're the children wrong.
No, really, all of them need a little work out there.
I feel like Monica could do it. Don't you feel like Monica
I
knows
know
how to
Monica
Dutch?
Can do it. Yeah, I know she can do it.
Maybe we'll try to convince her to get out there.
A little later in the show when she joins us. Don't you worry about that. Okay, so here we are. We're at Centennial Olympic Park. And my goodness, is this the place to be tonight?
It absolutely is. And we heard Tracy and Rob mention Angelica Hale. She is one of the performers tonight. We heard her practice. Earlier, she sounds stunning, and it's not like she's just coming out to sing one song. She's got multiple songs she plans to sing. I mean, we talked to her on the show.
Yes.
She's what, 14 right now?
14 years old.
We asked her, when did you realize you could sing?
And that's
you
what know. We said, because there's a difference between singing and singing. And she said she noticed it, right?
She says, when I was about 5 years old, I was thinking, are you kidding me? When I was five, I was still trying to bring down the house with Twinkle Twinkle Little Star.
Right.
You know,
right.
I was still on my Miss Mary Mac, you know.
Not bad.
Oh, thank you.
I'm impressed. No, we're going to leave that to Angelica. But listen, here at Centennial Park, you know, there is so much that this place offers, and that's really why this is the perfect location for a spotlight look of Atlanta. Let's tell you a little bit more about Centennial Olympic Park.
Centennial Olympic Park is really one of the legacy venues from the Centennial Olympic Games from 1996, that it's much more than just a venue.
Billy's idea was the vision to transform downtown. It made the Olympics, it's made the city, and it's made our future.
Centennial Olympic Park is a great gift to the city of Atlanta. It's really revitalized downtown, but it's really been a great environmental attribute for the city as well. It helps with stormwater management, it helps with the urban heat island effect. It's one of the first and only green spaces downtown Atlanta has.
There is a divine creativity in green space that we need not only in the bricks and mortar of our cities, but we need it in our hearts to see children and families walking through this place. not to mention when we have a concert and the whole place comes alive.
It just seems like it's a bigger backyard. Whether people are coming for a music festival or they're just coming to the park for the day, it's a great spot for any of those things.
Centennial Olympic Park is set apart from all of the other Olympic parks that I've seen around the world because the gates are open. It's a welcoming place for all of Atlanta, not for elite athletes, not for the corporate community, but for everyday Atlantans and for the tourists and visitors who come each and every day.
Both of my parents are immigrants from Nigeria, and when they were deciding on where to go, they literally said, let's go to Atlanta because that's where the Olympics are going. Knowing that legacy is something that I carry with me all the time. And for the next generation, it's just one of those things of carrying the dream forward. A vibrant city like Atlanta and a gathering space like the park, that's where the future is.
It's really important for this generation and future generations to ensure that the community aspect, the economic aspect, and the environmental attributes of Centennial Olympic Park continue to live forward in the future.
My dream for Centennial Olympic Park is that it will continue to serve as a beacon, calling the people of Atlanta, all of our visitors, our guests, to celebrate what we share in common. The great diversity of this community, the fun, the beauty of the park, and at the same time, to see something that has survived this span of time and honestly gets better every year. That's what the park does.
You know, I always say this, you have not been to Atlanta if you have not been to Centennial Olympic Park. And I know this place has a really special place in a lot of people's hearts because of the 1996 Olympics. Yeah. My mom and my dad both worked in the Olympics when it came here. So I know it gave a lot of people jobs and a lot of people remember being here for that really exciting time for the city. Of course, it's gorgeous. You know, when you're a kid, you remember running through the fountains, running through the grass, just getting to be a kid. That's what this reminds me of when I see everybody out here and all these families. It's just like a step back in time for me almost.
Yeah, and even someone who's newer to the city, I knew about this.
Right.
I knew about, you know, one of the first things when I got here, people are talking about Centennial Olympic Park. And they're like, okay, tell me about it.
Yeah.
And everybody that you run into can tell you about it. If
Absolutely.
They've been in Atlanta and they've lived here, they will tell you. And they're proud of this place, too. And you can see that. Look at how many people are out here right now. People are excited to call this place home, and it truly shows.
And let me tell you, when they added Skyview to the area, icing on the cake. If you have not been to Skyview yet, it is incredible. We actually got to go as we were filming some shoots for Look Up Atlanta.
Yeah.
And the VIP.
Ooh. See, I'm telling you, if you're going to do it, you got to do VIP now.
And it's going to cost you.
It's going to cost you just a little something, but it is going to be worth it for sure. But one thing that I've got to say about Centennial Olympic Park, okay, so I remember growing up and I remember coming here on a family trip. We went to the Georgia Aquarium, went to the World of Coca-Cola.
Right.
Everything is just right around this area.
Yes.
So if you come to Centennial Olympic Park, you can spend a whole day just going to the couple of the spots that are around here.
And not needing to find parking a thousand different times.
Correct.
Just get here and everything else is figured out.
If you need something for the kids to do, come on down here and that's all you got to do. You've got a whole day planned for you.
Absolutely. All right. So the show continues with Tracy and Rob. They are standing by with another very special guest, if I could talk. Hey, guys.
Hey, guys. Yeah, we've had a few special guests this evening. It's been a lot of fun so far, and thanks for leading us into this. You guys have talked a lot about the five aspirations, right? They covered a lot of different things leading up to Look Up Atlanta to promote this and got to experience a lot of fun things. They knew them by heart, but I had to write them down, guys. So we got attractions. We got appetite.
Yes.
We've got accommodations. We have athletics. And we have the arts.
We do. We have the arts. And that brings us to our guests this evening. And we do want to introduce William Buddy Langley. He's the guest conductor for the Atlanta Symphony Youth Orchestra. And Tobias Liu, the concert master. Welcome to you both. Thanks for stopping by.
Thank you for having us.
You carved out some time because I know you guys were they're performing tonight. So this is a big deal that they kind of took some time to spend with us. What are you most looking forward to? Because you're going to be on the center stage there. Not that this is common for you at all. But this is a great celebration tonight, an opportunity for many Atlantans to hear the Youth Symphony that they may not have heard before, right?
This is a great opportunity for us to be here in front of all of these people. I think the number one thing is to show that classical music is for everyone, not just people in tuxedos and gowns. You can wear your shorts, you can have your picnic basket.
Come as you are.
Come as you are, exactly. It's for everyone.
Wonderful.
Well, I was just going to say, you guys are up here, you're having a fun time. I see the smiles on your faces, but you've got a serious performance to put on. It's fun, but are you stressed at all?
I'm nervous, but I love it.
I love the honesty.
I mean, I'm an Atlantan born and raised, so I grew up going to these kind of events, right. Symphony concerts, youth orchestra concerts, and they were kind of the inspiration for myself and so many of my peers to start pursuing music making at a higher level. So it's just really amazing to now be able to be a part of that, and I'm really excited and honored. So.
Tobias, tell us a little bit about what it takes to get into the youth orchestra, because this is a very rigorous thing they put you through in order to make the cut, right?
There's several rounds of auditions, and once you get in, it's kind of serves as an intensive training ground for serious young musicians across Metro Atlanta, and also we have kids from Macon and Columbus and even Chattanooga that come down here, and we train with the mentorship of Atlanta Symphony musicians and conductors, and it's really great.
I spoke generally about the arts, Atlanta being a destination for the arts, but music among the arts is very high on that list,
yes,
of arts. Atlanta has a long history of music, all different genres, and obviously classical music is what the symphony is about.
Absolutely.
Talk about the role in making Atlanta a strong music destination from the symphony's perspective.
I mean, the symphony alone has 27 Grammys and counting. I mean, they're incredible. Wow. And they haven't even been around that long. I mean, a long time, but, you know, compared to other orchestras,
sure,
not as long, and 27 Grammys, which is huge. The ASYO, in particular, is one of the greatest in the country. I mean, you have pull from all of these areas, like Tobias said, you know, that are coming, all of these kids that are coming, and they are literally the cream of the crop in this orchestra. So it's a great training ground for those that want to go on to a career in classical music, and even people that don't. You know, it's great for them to have this, the camaraderie and also just the leadership training.
And we will hear the performance tonight during the fireworks?
Yes.
What is that like? Tobias, tell me a little bit about that, because, you know, you're kind of performing almost like a soundtrack to a movie in a way, you know, and that just gives you chills.
I'd
when
be
you,
distracted.
Like, listen,
right.
When you listen and you're watching, and it's just like, oh, all the senses are all just kind of coming together. How do you practice for fireworks?
I think the biggest part for me is, like, when I look at the orchestra, there's different kids from different backgrounds all over Metro Atlanta, but we're kind of all here for the same purpose, you know, to learn to listen to each other, to create a unified sound. And I think what excites me the most about doing this kind of thing is that we can, by learning to listen to each other, we can bring together the city of Atlanta, right, and to celebrate. So.
Tobias, you told me you were nervous for this performance tonight, but I read that you performed your first solo at the age of 11.
Yes.
I don't know if I buy it, man. I mean, 11 years old doing a solo seems like way more nerve-wracking than out here. All these people are just trying to have some fun.
I get nervous for everything.
It's because you care.
Right.
You know, for sure.
Right. Yeah. That's wonderful. Tobias, buddy, thank you so much.
Thank you.
We appreciate it. We are so looking forward to the performance. We will let you go and practice. So stay with us for just a hot minute, though. And we do want to thank you for watching. And make sure you come on out, because the night is just getting started. There's still some space on the lawn out here at Centennial Olympic Park.
Do you see that sun peeking out there?
What do you know? And it's a little bit cooler, too. I think the clouds have parted, and it will be a gorgeous night for fireworks, to listen to the Atlanta Symphony Youth Orchestra, to, you know, hear our performers as well. It will
Angelica
be an amazing
Hale
night. Angelica Hale
incredible.
Will be singing as well. Look at all the people out here. There's food, there's events, there's so much to do. Come on out to Centennial Olympic Park and continue to watch right there at home on Peachtree TV. Look up Atlanta. We're back right after the break.